Today's April 19, 2024, and if we just rewind the clock 1 year, we saw the release of ChatGPT 4 alongside plugins and a huge support from Microsoft with Bing. Since then, we've seen GPT-4 grow from like an alpha release to an actual product. GPT 3.5 is now free. And tools like DALL-E 3 have joined the fold. And I don't even want to talk about Sora, the video generative tool. That thing gives me existential crisis. If videos are being generated like that now, I can't even imagine what next year will be like. Now, it might feel like OpenAI is the only player in town, but that's far from the truth. Let's go back to 2023, right when GPT-4 launched. If you remember, around March, a thing called Llama leaked on 4chan, which was an internal language model built by Meta. And since then, it has evolved faster. So much faster. Fast forward to today, the guy who single-handedly inspired half the startups in Silicon Valley just announced what... Wait a second. Okay. Much better. Ready to take on OpenAI and the Octagon, Mark Zuckerberg just announced Llama 3. And it's starting to feel like that they're not the underdog anymore. You now have a very familiar ChatGPT-like interface. And honestly, it kind of feels faster. Just in general, the whole perplexity-inspired UI is kind of pleasing. It looks good. It integrates both Bing and Google, which I think is the first. Image generation also creates GIFs, very social media. And it will be an assistant way beyond the 2D screen. You'll have that on your Ray-Bans. Yeah, take that, Tony Stark. This certainly is very exciting. As AI becomes more publicly accessible, and did I forget to mention this whole thing is free? Yeah, as AI becomes more publicly accessible, there's a level to the playground. But we shouldn't lose sight of what AI is actually capable of in the wider scope of the industry. Just think of some examples like full self-driving by Tesla, or robotics, how AI has been leveraged in robotics by Boston Dynamics. And we can't forget rockets. I mean, they've been flying since before Will Smith had that iconic spaghetti. And just in the last week, Microsoft announced its video tool, VASA-1. I don't even want to talk about that. I guess I'll just show you.
I would say that we as readers are not meant to look at him and...
Yeah, that whole thing from one image. One. So I guess whenever I want to join a meeting, I could either turn my camera on or turn it off. Or... But that's just it. While we debate if AI is actually a net positive or negative for humanity, or is it even useful, one thing is for sure, it's getting better. And it's getting faster at getting better. As much as I'd like to believe like creativity in itself might not be threatened by AI, I'm not naive. I have to admit, we really need to start thinking creatively, like very creatively, about the larger scope of the problems that we can solve. While AI can handle some of the mundane tasks really quickly, it allows us more time to figure out bigger problems. As AI evolves rapidly, the question is, are we?